Well, hello everyone, it's Kari, and today I'm excited to bring you another card with a look into Wonderland. I'm going to be using a brand new die set from Missing Stamps. This is the Woodgrain Frame Die. It is beautiful. It comes with a frame like this that has the woodgrain impression in it. So when you die cut this, it creates a woodgrain frame. There's also an alphabet that comes with this set, and I'm not going to use that today on this card, but it is awesome. I don't know if you can see the wood grain here. You'll be able to see it a little better when I ink it up later on in this video. I'm also going to be using this Forest Path stamp set, which is so beautiful. It also has some great sentiments in it. And I'm going to use the Let's Ride stamp set with this tree. I love this set. I'm just going to be using the aspen trees today, and I'm also going to cut them out with the coordinating dies. It is so lovely to have coordinating dies, especially when you want to make a card with a glimpse into Wonderland like this one. So fun. I'm going to start by stamping those trees on some Bristol smooth paper. I'm using Bristol Smooth because I want to use some watercolor markers with this one. I'm actually going to cut this cardstock down so that I have two pieces, and I'll stamp one and then the other. I'm going to use some VersaFine Onyx black ink and then some clear embossing powder over the top. I really like to do this when I'm using watercolor like this or even watercolor markers, because it tends to keep that watercolor right inside the different wells of the embossing powder. So this is my favorite go-to trick. I've got some Zig Clean Color Real Brush markers here, and I'm just gonna take this light gray shadow color and outline the outside portions of each of these trees. Some very light coloring here today. It's hard to see in the video, but it does add quite a bit of interest on the card because it creates those shadows. So I'm just going to do this down the edges or the sides of all of those trees, and then to color up the leaves, I'm going to use a couple different shades of green. A darker shade on the inside part of the leaves, and then I'll blend that out with a lighter shade of green. These markers are really fun to use because you can blend them with each other. You can use a water brush if you want to, but you could also use a lighter color to blend out the darker color like I'm doing here on these leaves. It's so fast and quick and fun to see. I'm just gonna add a little darker portion on the inside as well, and then I'll color in that grass really easily and blend that out with a water brush. When you cut this out, you're not going to be able to see all of that blended water at the bottom you'll see here. It's going to cut out most of that, but it really will make it look like you've colored it perfectly. So I love that. So we've got our trees. Now we're going to stamp the background with that Forest Path stamp set. I'm using a really light gray oxide ink here to stamp it out. This is Pumice Stone Distress Oxide. That's going to create just an illusion of this background, really nice and light. Now I'll take my water brush and just blend out some of that color on those stones. That's going to color our stones up with that same gray ink. And now to add a little color to those trees, I'm going to blend on some oxide ink in Shabby Shutters all over those trees. You can see I'm using a smaller brush for this, and that makes it easy to get into those small little areas. Then a little darker green oxide ink with the Rustic Wilderness ink just on the very centers of each of those trees. That's going to give it some drama. And you'll notice I'm dabbing off my brush every time before I go in with the color so I don't get big splotches of color. It's nice and soft. And there's the beginnings of our background. Now to add a little bit of sky, I'm using this Speckled Egg Distress ink and my Bitty blending brush here to add a little bit of sky. And to give those tree trunks a little more definition, I will use a Prismacolor pencil in a light gray and color up each of the tree trunks of the background. This seems like a small step, but it really does add some more definition and drama to the background. I think it really adds a lot. So it's very simple to do as well. An easy, easy step. Now I'm going to take that same pumice stone distress oxide ink and color up the frame with the wood grain to it. The wood grain is starting to come out. You can really start to see the design, but that's not all. We're going to also go in with a darker green shade of distress oxide to really make this pop. And this is the forest moss color. Look at how it really does bring out those colors, bring out the wood grain, and it's going to look great with our background. So you'll notice I'm just adding that forest moss nice and light around the edges. And then I'll go in with my Zigs and color up the Cheshire Cat. Now there is a brand new Cheshire Cat set. I ended up using the smaller Cheshire Cat from the Alice stamp set so that it would fit on my trees. You can use any of the cats that you have, and I just love this little striped guy. He's got a little smile and he's kind of hiding behind his tail here. He's so cute. So I've got a purple and a pink, and I'm just going to blend those out with my water brush. This is so relaxing and fun to do, and also very, very easy. Now to add some footprints, I have the footprint stencil here, and I'm just going to add a few of them down the path so it looks like you're walking right into Wonderland. I'm just going to tape off those other ones on the sides so I don't accidentally add some where I don't want to. I'm going to use some dark purple for this with a small brush. And there's our footprints walking down the path into Wonderland. Now it's time to put this whole thing together. So I've taped that frame in place so I could place the inside part of this perfectly on the panel. And now I'm going to add some foam tape to that frame so I can pop that up for some dimension. You could easily turn this into a shaker card if you wanted. Today I just wanted that frame open, so it looks like you could just jump right in and head into Wonderland. So for the aspen trees, I'm going to add some foam tape to the backs of those as well, cutting it down so they're small enough to fit on the tree trunks. Then I'll add a little bit of liquid adhesive to the top and the bottom of the trees so that they're glued onto that frame. So the foam tape is just on the inside, so it's up the same amount as the frame. And I'll add that to both sides there. So look at that. It's going to create our focal piece right there, which is the pathway back to Wonderland. And there's the Cheshire Cat. He's ready to greet you. I've stamped a sentiment here that says, "Think of it as an adventure." And I stamped that and then backed that with some purple cardstock to match the cat. And then I'll just glue him right to that tree right there. And the last thing is just adding some enamel dots. I happen to have the perfect light purple enamel dots here that I'm going to add. You could also use sequins or gems or whatever you want, but I thought these finished it off perfectly. And it's like there's always something to see when you're in Wonderland, right? Things peeking out from behind the trees. So here is the last step, and that is, of course, to add a little glitter to those trees because this is a magical land, and I think magical lands deserve a little glitter on their trees. So I'm just adding a small amount. Not very much at all, and I'm just going to kind of blend that out a little with the nozzle. And here is a look at our magical card, the picture frame into Wonderland. I hope you really enjoyed this project today. I had such a great time creating this. As always, I will link all of the products below if you want to go take a look. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it and subscribe to the channel. We hope to see you again real soon. Bye-bye.